Hello students, how are you? I hope you all are good. So today in this lecture we are going to discuss a problem on Canis method for a sway frame, right? So see, this is your frame. For BC member, moment of inertia is I, and for AB and CD this is I. So this is your sway frame because this load, vertical load, is acting at 3 meter from B, and C, from C it is at 5 meter. Okay, so see, this is your sway frame. So how we will analyze this sway frame by using Canis method? So our step number one is same, that is calculation of fixed end moments. So step one is your fixed end moments. Fixed end moments, right? Already we have discussed how to identify a frame is whether sway or non-sway. So this is a sway frame. So first we are going to calculate the fixed end moments. So see, your AB span and CD span is non-loaded, means there is no load on AB span and CD span, right? So fixed end moments in these span will be zero. So MF AB will be equal to MF BA will be equal to MF CD, which is also equal to MF DC, which is equal to zero, because there is no load on this spans. Now coming to this BC span, there is a load of 160 kilonewton at a distance of 3 meter from B and 5 meter from C. So MFBC will be minus WAB square upon L square, right? Because this load is not eccentric, it is not acting at the center. So WAB square upon L square, W is your minus 160 is your W into A. A is your 3 meter. B here 5 upon L is 8. If you will calculate it, you will get minus 187.5 kilonewton meter. Next, MFCB, again W plus W B A square upon L square, here plus 160 into 5, because A is 5, into B, B is 3, B square, sorry, A square, B is 5 and A is your 3. So A is 3 square, 160 into 5 into 3 square upon 8 square. If you will calculate it, you will get plus 112.5 kilonewton meter, right? So we got MFBC and MFCB, MFAB, MFBA, MFCD and MFDC. Is zero because there is no load on these spans. So our first step is completed with this fixed end moments. Now we will go for the calculation of rotation factor. Okay, so next step we will go for the calculation of rotation factor. So rotation factor, see here, how many joints are there? Two joints, B and C joints. For B joint there are two members, BC and BA. For C joint there are two members, CB and CD, right? So if for B joint you will see BA, far end is fixed, BC, far end is continuous. For C joint, far end is continuous, and for D, CD, D is your fixed. So the formula will be 4EI by LLD, right? So next we will calculate step two, that is your rotation factor. And we know the rotation factor is nothing, minus of 0.5 times of distribution factor. Okay, so step two, that is rotation factor. Okay, so how many joints? Two joints. So first we will write joints, then member. Then we will calculate the stiffness of that member, then total stiffness, then we will calculate distribution factor, and then finally rotation factor. How many joints? Two joints, so B and C. How many members are connected to B? Two members, that is BC and BA. Here also for C, CB and CD. So for BC span, you can see, for BC, C is continuous, so 4EI upon L. So 4EI, I is 2I upon 8. So 4 E into 2i upon 8, which is equal to EI. Here for BA, 4EI by L. So 4EI by 4. 4EI by 4. That is also EI. Again for CB, 4 into 4E into I. I is your 2I into divided by L. L is your 8. So 4E into 2I upon 8. That is again EI. And here for this 4EI by L, that is EI. Now total stiffness. Total stiffness at a joint. So see here at B joint, two members are there, BC and BA. So for BC, EI, for BA also EI. So total stiffness will be 2EI. Similarly in C joint, at C joint, two members, CB and CD. So EI by EI plus EI, 2EI. Distribution factor is individual upon total. So EI divided by 2EI, that is half. Here also it will be half. EI by 2EI, again EI by 2EI, again EI by 2EI, and again EI by 2EI. So these all is your 1 by 2, 1 by 2, 1 by 2, and 1 by 2. Rotation factor is nothing. Minus of 0.5 times of distribution factor. Whatever the distribution factor you got, minus of 0.5 times. So minus 0.5 of 1 by 2, it will be minus 1 by 4. Similarly, here also it will be minus 1 by 4. Minus 1 by 4 and minus 1 by 4. So we got our rotation factor for BC member, BA member, CB member, and CD member rotation factor. These are the rotation factor. Minus 1 by 4, minus 1 by 4, minus 1 by 4, minus 1 by 4. This is our step number 2. This step number 2 is over now. Now, since this is a problem of sway frame, right? So there is some extra step. That step is called as calculation of displacement factor. Because this frame will displace. This is the frame. So this frame will displace like this, right? So we need to calculate the displacement factor. By what displacement factor it will displace. So for displacement factor, we will go for the third step now. We'll calculate displacement factor. Format is same. Just like rotation factor only, we will calculate displacement factor also. Only the relation between displacement factor and distribution factor is slightly different. Okay. Here vertical member. Directly member, then stiffness K, that is stiffness. Then total stiffness. Then distribution factor and then displacement factor. And displacement factor is nothing minus of 3 by 2 times of distribution factor. Minus 3 by 2 times of distribution factor is nothing, your displacement factor. How many vertical members are there? Because in displacement factor, this vertical members will displace, right? So only we will take vertical member. Vertical members is AB and CD. So only we will take here AB and we will take here CD. AB stiffness, you can see it for AB member stiffness will be 4EI by L. So 4EI by 4, that is EI. And for this also it will be 4EI by L. So 4EI by 4, which is equal to EI. Total stiffness 2EI. So distribution factor for this also half, for this also half. So displacement factor will be minus 3 by 2 times of 1 by half. So it will be minus 3 by 4 and here also minus 3 by 4. So we have calculated with this step number 3. This was your step number 3. What we have calculated? We have calculated displacement factor. Displacement factor. Okay. This is your additional step. If you are going to analyze a sway frame, then only we will go for this third step, that is displacement factor. Otherwise, first step fixed moment. Okay. Then rotation factor and directly we will go for the iteration. But in this step, in this problem means for sway problem, there is one more step, that is calculation of displacement factor, right? Now we will go for the process of iterations, right? That is your step number 4. So step 4. Before step 4, let's make this diagram. like this. A, this is your B, C, and this is your D. Now write the fixed end moments, right? So fixed end moment for BC and CB only we have. This is minus 187.5 and this is plus 112.5. Okay, now we will write the rotation factors. So for rotation factor for AB member is minus 1/4. For each and every member is minus 1/4 only. So minus 1/4. Here also minus 1/4 and here also minus 1/4. Okay, because for all members it is same only, right? This is also minus 1/4. Okay, so we have written this distribution factor, distribution rotation factors, as well as fixed end moments. Fixed end moments above the beam, distribution factor for members, right? -1/4, -1/4, -1/4, and -1/4. Now we will write the displacement factor, where it will displace at these points, right? So displacement factor we will write here. Here that is -3/4, and here also it is -3/4. Okay. Now next, fixed end moments at the joint. So fixed end moments, summation of fixed end moments at the joint means whatever the moments we got on the right and left, we need to add. So on the right it is -187.5, on left it is zero, nothing is there. So here it will be -187.5. And here also same situation, 112.5, here it is zero. So plus 112.5. So these are our values. We fed up with all these values, fixed end moments, then summation of fixed end moments, rotation factor and displacement factor. Okay, each and every values we have written here. Now we will go for the iteration number one. Okay, so let's go for a step number. This is a step number four, that is iteration. So iteration number one, first we will go for the iteration number one. So you know the formula. If you want to calculate the contribution value, that is rotation factor into summation of fixed end moments plus near contribution value plus far contribution value, right? So iteration one. Iteration one. M dash BA for B joint, M dash BA and M dash BC. For C joint, M dash CB and M dash CD, right? So rotation factor is for every 1/4, for this also 1/4, for here also it is 1/4, and for this also it is 1/4, because rotation factor is same. Now coming to summation of fixed end moments, for B joint, what is the summation of fixed end moments? This -187.5, -187.5, here also -187.5. Now you are standing at B, BA. So A will be your near contribution value. At this, what is the contribution value here? Still it is zero. Plus far contribution value. So if you are standing at here, so A is your near, so BC, C will be your far contribution. So at this, every contribution value in initial stage will be zero only. Here, what is the value? Zero only, right? So zero. If you will calculate it, you will get it as plus 46.87 kilonewton meter. Similarly, next, for this situation also same, plus 46.87 kilonewton meter. As soon as you get the value, you just enter these values there. Okay, so that we can use the value in next step, right? So we got for BA. For BA, we got 46.87. So just write here plus 46.87. As well as we got for BC also plus 46.87. So here also you write plus 46.87. Okay. Now next, M dash CB. Summation of fixed moment is 112.5. So 112.5. Now we are talking about CB. So B is your near contribution and D will be far. So near contribution value, we got new value, that is 46.87. So we will write here 46.87 plus far contribution is D, still it is here zero. So if you will calculate it, you will get this value as minus 39.84 kilonewton meter. Similarly for this, fixed end moments will be 112.5 only, plus for this near will be D and far will be 46.87. So 0 plus 46.87. Same, minus 39.84 kilonewton meter. Okay. Till here, it is same as beam or as well as non-sway. But now we need to calculate M double dash AB and M double dash CD. What is this M double dash AB and M double dash CD? That is contribution value in vertical members. If you want to calculate contribution value in vertical members, because this is a problem of sway, right? So in this sway problem, vertical members will also move, right? There will be some displacement. So we need to calculate the contribution values in vertical members. So if you want to calculate this contribution values in vertical members, what will happen? Displacement factor into sum of contribution value at top of the vertical member plus sum of contribution value at bottom of the vertical member. Displacement factor into sum of contribution value at the top of the vertical member plus sum of contribution value at the bottom of the vertical member. So before going to this, we should feed these values. CB, we have minus 39.8, CV, so minus 39.84, and here also minus 39.84 for CD. For CD also minus 39.84. So we have entered this value. Now see, what is CV in vertical member? Displacement factor. Okay, we have this displacement factor minus 3 by 4. Into sum of contribution value at the top of vertical member. At the top of vertical member, this is the vertical member. At the top, what is the contribution value? Plus 46.87. Here it is minus 39.84. Plus sum of contribution value at the bottom of vertical member. At the bottom, what is this? Here it is zero, right? Here nothing is there. Here obviously the contribution value is zero. So sum of these two plus sum of these two into displacement factor will give us the contribution value in vertical member, right? So just we will calculate this vertical. How many vertical members are there? Obviously two, AB and CD. So M double dash AB will be equal to displacement factor. Displacement factor is nothing, minus 3/4 for this member. So minus 3/4 into top plus 46.87 minus 39.84. So 46.87 minus 39.84 plus at the bottom, both the values are zero. If you will calculate it, you will get minus 5.27 kilonewton meter. And again, same M double dash CD will be again displacement factor is minus 3/4 into top 46.87 minus 39.84. Again, the bottom is zero, right? So this value will be minus again 5.27 kilonewton meter. Okay, these two are the additional things in this. After iteration number one, we have to calculate the contribution values in vertical members also. So these are the two vertical members, AB and CD is your vertical member. So M double dash AB value is minus 5.27 and M double dash CD is your minus 5.27, again same. Now from iteration number two, the formula for finding these contribution values will change. We have calculated these contribution values by using formula RF into summation of fixed end moments plus NCV plus FCV. Now that formula is going to change now. Now next, what will be the formula for in iteration number two? If you will go for iteration number two, a formula, there will be a slightly change in the formula. What will be that change? Remember, till step number one, there will be no change in the formula. Same formula, rotation factor into sum of fixed end moments plus NCV plus FCV. Now there will be slightly change in the formula. What will be that formula? Let's see. There is a slight change only. So now if you want to calculate the contribution value, then rotation factor, okay, into summation of fixed end moments, okay, plus near contribution value, that is also okay, plus far contribution value. Till iteration number one, we are using this formula only, right? Here, additional term will come, summation of displacement contribution value. We have to add the summation of displacement contribution value also. Whatever the value we have got here, this is displacement contribution value, right? So we have to add whenever you are going for the next iteration, because in iteration number one, before iteration number one, what was the value of this? It was simply zero before iteration number one. After iteration number one, we have some value, minus 5.27. So we cannot ignore this term. So we have to add this term. So from iteration number two, we will include this term also in finding its contribution value. So iteration two. So in iteration two, M dash, again for B joint, M dash PA and M dash BC. This rotation factor is minus 1/4. For this also minus 1/4. Summation of fixed end moments, minus 187.5. So minus 187.5. Here also minus 187.5. Plus near contribution value. So here near contribution value for BA. A will be your near. So here it is zero only, right? So zero. Plus far contribution value, it will be here. So minus 39.84. So minus 39.84. Plus summation of contribution displacement contribution value. What is that displacement contribution value here? You can see minus 5.27. So minus 5.27. We got this value, right? Minus 5.2. So minus 5.27, if you will calculate it, you will get 58.15 kilonewton meter. This additional term will come. Okay. M double dash AB means for AB and BA, minus 5.27. M double dash CD means for CD and DC. Since these two values are same, so no need to see. If these two values are different, then we have to see. M double dash AB means we will use this value for which span? For AB, M dash AB and M dash BA, right? And M double dash CD we will use for M dash CD and M dash DC. But here the values are same, so no need to worry, only both values will be same only, right? So again, just we need to enter these values. Now we got 58.15, so we will enter this 58.15 here plus 58.15. yeah, we got minus 5.27, so we will enter here also. We got minus 5.27 here also, same, minus 5.27. okay, next, 187 plus near contribution value for BC. If you are seeing BC, so at C will be your near, at A will be far. So at A it is zero only, at C it is minus 30. Don't consider this because this is displacement contribution value, right? This is not contribution value. Still the contribution value at A and D is zero only, and it will be zero only, right? So for BC, C is your near and A is your far. So at C 39.84 and at A zero. So minus 39.84 plus zero, again minus 5.27, the summation of displacement contribution value, you will get this value as again plus 58.15 kilonewton meter. So it is also m dash bc. Sorry, m dash ba and m dash bc. Sorry, this is m dash bc already I have entered here, 58.15. Here also for m dash ba we got 58.15. So here also 58.15 only, right? So next we will go for m dash cb. Rotation factor 1/4 only. Summation of fixed end moment. See here at c 112.5. So 112.5 plus near contribution value for this cb. Near contribution will be at b. And far contribution value will be at D. So near is 58.15 and far is 0. So 58.15 plus 0 and this minus 5.27. So minus 5.27. If you will calculate this value, you will get minus 41.35 kilonewton meter. So we need to update this value for M dash CB. CB minus 41.35 minus 41.35. Next, m dash cd, again rotation factor 1/4 into summation of fixed end moments 112.5 plus near contribution value for cd. D will be near and b will be far, so d is 0 again and b is 58.15 minus 5.27. so this value will be minus 41.35 kilonewton meter, right? So update here also minus 41.35. Okay, so we have calculated this contribution value. Now again we will calculate m double dash ab in this iteration and m double dash cd, because our top values has been changed. Now initially the top values was 46.87 minus 39.84, now it is 58.15 and 41.35. And bottom is still zero. So these top values changes. So our displacement contribution value also will change. So displacement factor is minus 3/4 into top 58.15 plus minus 41.35. So minus 41.35 plus zero plus zero. So if you will calculate, you will get minus 12.60 kilonewton meter. Similarly, here also minus 3/4 into same 58.15 minus 41.35 plus 0 plus 0. So it is minus 12.60 kilonewton meter. So these are the values of our iteration number 2. So we will update here minus 5.27 and then next value is minus 12.60. Minus 12.60. Here also minus 12.60. So this is our iteration number 2. Now we will go for same iteration number 3, right? So each and every value will be changed. These values will be same. Okay. Only these values will change. So we will update these values. Now see m dash ba rotation factor and here for distribution factor already. This is iteration number 3. Now minus 1/4. This fixed end moment is minus 187.5. For this also minus 187.5, 112.5, 112.5. Near contribution value for ba. A will be your near, so it will be 0. Plus far contribution value. So a is near, then obviously for b, c will be far. So minus 41.35. Minus 41.35, and we got this before values minus 12.60, minus 12.60, right? So our value, this value will come 60.36. 60.36. Similarly here also plus near will be minus 41.35, far will be 0, minus 12.60. So it will be also 60.36. So update these values, plus 60.36. Here also plus 60.36. Next, CB, for CB, B will be near. So 60.36 plus D will be far. So 0 minus 12.60. So this value will be minus 40.07 kilonewton meter. These all are in kilonewton meter. So 40.07. So here we will write minus 40.07. Similarly here, see, near contribution value will become far, far will become near. Just interchange for a joint. So it will be 60.36 minus 12.60. So it will be minus 40.07 kilonewton meters. So similarly, again, we will update here minus 40.07. Next, we need to calculate M double dash AB and N double dash CD again, because our top values has been changed. Top value is plus 60.36 and minus 40.07. So 60.36 minus 40.07, and the bottom value is still zero. Here also 60.36 minus 40.07. So if you will calculate these values, if you are calculating this value, you will get these values as minus 15.22, again minus 15.22 kilonewton meter. This is also kilonewton meter. So update these values, minus 15.22, here also minus 15.22. Okay, so similarly, we will go for iteration number 4 and iteration number 5, because here, see that there is a difference in these last two values. So again, we will go for the iteration number 4. Again, only these values will change. Okay. So now again for BA. We have updated all the values, minus 1 by 4, minus 187.5, A, at A it is 0, and at C, minus 40.07, and your last displacement contribution value is minus 15.22. So if you will calculate, you will get plus 60.70. Just update this BA, plus 60.70. Next here, far will be minus 40, near will be minus 40.07, and far will become 0, and this will be minus 15.22. Then again you will get plus 60.70. So here also plus 60.70. These are in kilonewton meter. This is also kilonewton meter. Next, 112.5 plus for CB. CB, B is your near, so 60.70. And D is your far, so 0, minus 15.22. So this value you will get minus 39.50, minus 39.50. So just update this value, minus 39.50. Next, for this 0 plus 60.70 minus 15.22. If you will calculate it again, you will get minus 39.50 only, right? Kilonewton meter. Similar steps, whatever we are doing in iteration 1, 2, 3, that will be in the same in the 4, only the values will change. Now here the value, top values, just put these values here also, minus 39.50. So top values is 60.70 minus 39.50 means 60.70. Minus 39.50 plus 0, 0. Here also 60.70 minus 39.50 plus 0 and 0. You will get these values as minus 15.90 kilonewton meter. 15.90. So update this value, minus 15.90. Here also minus 15.90. Now we will go for iteration number 5, because last two values, see, still there is some difference, right? So we'll better we go for one more iteration, it will be better for us, so that our calculation will be very, very approximate to the actual value, right? So again, these values will only change, remaining thing will be same, right? Now again, we will write for BA, A will be near, so 0, B will be far, so B is your plus, B is your minus 39.50, so minus 39.50, and previous displacement contribution value is minus 15.90. So if you will calculate, you will get 60.73 kilonewton meter. Next here also, minus 39.50 plus 0 minus 15.90, you will get plus 60.73 kilonewton meter. So here also we will update now, 60.73, it is 60.73, and here also it is plus 60.73. Next, for this CB, it will be 60.73 plus 0 minus 15.90, you will get this value as minus 39.33 kilonewton meter. Similarly, here also 73 minus 15.90, so this is minus 39.33 kilonewton meter. Okay, so we will update here minus 39.33, here also minus 39.33. Now for this top value is 60.73 minus 39.33, and bottom values are still 0. If you will calculate, you will get minus 16.05. Here also 60.73 minus 39.33 plus 0 plus 0, again you will get minus 16.05 kilonewton meter. 16.05, so write it here, minus 16.05, here also minus 16.05. So we have done with iteration number 5 also. This was your iteration number 5. So till here you can stop, otherwise you can go for iteration number 6. If you will go for iteration number 6, you will get very closer value, but here also you can see only 0.17 difference, here 0.15 difference is there. So till here we can stop. So this was our iteration number 5. So till iteration number 5 you can stop now, and after iterations, after stopping these, we will calculate the final moments, that is our final step, right? Step number 5, that is your calculation of final moments. This is easy, nothing is there, only you have to calculate one additional thing, that is displacement contribution value by using your displacement factor. Now again, in final moments also, there will be a role of your displacement contribution value. How? See here. For normal, what is the final moments formula? Final moment, if you want to calculate, then the formula was FEM, fixed end moments, plus 2 into near contribution value, plus far contribution value. This was the formula. Here one more additional thing will be distribution contribution value. Displacement contribution value we have to add for final moments. Let's say for final moments AB, fixed end moments, in first step we have calculated the fixed end moments. So for AB, the fixed end moments was 0 plus 2 into near contribution value. Near means at A. What is near contribution value at A? 0. Plus far contribution value. Far contribution value means B. At B, what is the value? 60.73. So 60.73. What is displacement contribution value? Final value, that is 16.05. So minus 16.05. You will calculate, you will get minus 44.68 kilonewton meter. Next, MBA. For MBA also, fixed end moment is 0 plus 2 into B will be your near, A will be far. So B value at B, it is 60.73. See, this 60.73. Plus far is 0, because far at A is, it is 0, minus 16.05. This value, displacement contribution value, is equal to plus 105.41 kilonewton meter. Now, MBC. For MBC, the See here for MBC, fixed moment is minus 187.5 plus 2 into near contribution. BC means at B is near, C is far. B is 60.73 plus far C. C is 39.33, so minus 39.33. Okay. Is equal to, now see here, this BC span is not a vertical member, right? So we will not add this displacement contribution value because this displacement contribution value is only for vertical members. So these two are BC and MCB. If you see this BC span, this is not a vertical, this is horizontal member. So we need not to add this displacement contribution value here. Simply we will do the original, that because here displacement contribution value is nothing, zero only, right? So if you will calculate it, you will get minus 105.37 kilonewton meter. Next for CB, again minus for CB, sorry, for C to B. CB fixed moment is 112.5 plus near contribution value will be minus 39.33 into 2 NCV plus FCV is 60.73, that will be your plus 94.61 kilonewton meter. See here 39.33 and 60.73. Now MCD and lastly MDC. MCD again, zero fixed moments plus 2 into near contribution value. C, at C, what is that? Contribute 39.33. So 39 minus 39.33 plus FCV, D, at D the FCV is 0, minus 16.053 because this is your vertical member, right? Will be equal to minus 94.71 kilonewton meter. Next, DC, fixed moment 0 plus at D is your near, so 2 into 0, minus 39.33 far, minus 16.05, that is equal to minus 55.38 kilonewton meter. So these are our final moments. If you want to check, so at B joint, see how many members are there? Two members, BA and BC. So for BA and for BC moments, add these two moments, it should be nearly equal to 0. 105.41, 105.37 means it is nearly equal to 0. Again at C joint, CD and CB, CD and CB. So add these two moments, it will be nearly equal to 0. If it is nearly equal to 0, okay, 94.61, 94.71 plus minus. So it will be nearly equal to 0.10. Okay, it is nearly equal to 0. It means our calculations are correct. So these were the final moments. So this problem is over. See, in this problem only you have to follow the steps. Each and a step, every step is same as the normal problem of Canis method. Only the thing is changed is due to this sway analysis, one more additional term is there, that is displacement factor. Okay. Due to this displacement factor, we will calculate displacement contribution value. And at the last, in the final moments, we will add this DCV, displacement contribution value for only vertical members. That's it. If you remember these 3 points, means it is a normal problem for a Canis method, right? So thank you.